Luis Sandoval, FightHub.com, a man, Joel Diaz. Joel, got a fighter here with a name that attracts a lot of attention, man. How much pressure do you guys feel always having to live up to that name?
Well, the pressure's on him, not on me, you know? Especially when I know that I have a great fighter, a very talented with a lot of potential. And the pressure is only on him because of the last name. You know, he knows that just being De La Hoya is pressure due to the fact that everybody wants to beat him. That's why he always prepares himself 100%. To me, I know there's no pressure because I know this kid is at another level compared to others. He trains hard, very disciplined. He hits hard, has speed, great footwork. And, you know, it's gonna take a lot in order for somebody to beat Diego De La Hoya. I see this kid when he came into the gym for the first time. I saw his potential, and I know that, you know, we've been improving him, you know, little by little, time after time, fight after fight. And I know that as of his last fight, he matured more. It's just a matter of time. But this kid right here is going to be a superstar in the sport.
How much longer, Joel, do you think? It's a couple years, 3 years before he gets to that level where he can start being, you know, a contender for a championship?
Well, he's still a kid. You know, he's still a baby in the sport. He only has 11 fights. There's no rush, you know. I mean, he's young, you know. He still has a lot more to learn. He needs to mature a little more, but I see him close to a world title. End of next year, you know. I'm looking at end of next year. He's already close to one of the top best fighters in the world.
The other fighter, Ruslan Provodnikov. You guys got a great win. We talked about it, Joel. How soon do you want him back in the ring? And are there opponents that he's told you about that he wants to fight next?
You know, after Ruslan Provodnikov's last fight, it was a great performance. I mean, even though a lot of people didn't know his opponent, who he was a tough kid. The kid was 20-0 with 18 knockouts, and he was hungry. And he told Provodnikov after the fight that he was there to beat him in order for him to be known, because nobody knows him. And, you know, he went in there, and even Ruslan told me after the fight, he says, this kid hits harder than Matisse. He says, I felt some punches, and he has more power than Matisse. But, you know, he really put into work some of the things that we worked in the gym, which made me happy because I hear the comments from his team. That was my main concern. You know, his team, to me, is the most important. What they think about the work we did, because they were always in the gym with me. And one of the things I got was the compliments of Ruslan Provodnikov using a little more defense than before. And besides the defense, you know, working the body more, attacking to the body, not getting so reckless like he usually does. So to me, that was a great compliment and a good relief that in a little bit of time that we worked, there was a little improvement. I'm not trying to change Ruslan. I'm just trying to make him better at what he does. I know he's a brawler. I know he's a heavy puncher. But, you know, time after time, we just need to keep repeating to him what exactly we need to do. Because once he gets in that ring, he goes in his own zone and he wants to break somebody.